lethal injection, go to sleep 6 feet deep. I give you a beat for the effort, but if I was 3'11", you'd look up to me. And for the record, you would suck a dick to fucking be me for a second.
Do you respond to it?
Do you respond to what?
His last...
Like on this...
Kill Shot?
Yes.
I had a clip ready. I'll tell you, I had a clip ready. I heard Kill Shot, and I put that shit back in the holster. I'm like, oh, word. All right. He called me a mumble rapper.
Had enough of this tatted up mumble rapper. How the fuck can him and I battle? I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune. So let's talk about it. I'm sick of your mumble rap mouth. Need to get the cock about it before we can even talk about it.
I thought Rap Devil was better than Kill Shot. I guess I'm in the minority.
Hey, somebody grab him some clippers. This fucking beard is weird. Tough talk from a rapper paying millions for security a year.
Because people been giving me flack.
Eminem is a great lyricist. I don't think anybody can deny that.
No, I didn't say Kill Shot was better. I just say Kill Shot wasn't trash.
Lick a boss like to get on my channel. Give your life to be a solidified. This motherfucking shit is like Rambo when he's out of bullets. So what good is a fucking machine gun when it's out of ammo?
I didn't say Kill Shot was trash. Oh, okay. I think Kill Shot was good. I just think Rap Devil was better.
What's that?
It's a six for me, dog.
It's a six for you?
Let me say, but I thought Rap Devil was executed.
Kill Shot was a leg shot. Rap Devil, we're talking about facts. You want to talk about man buns?
Stand, son, listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun?
Somebody grab him some clippers. This fucking beard is weird. This fucking beard is weird. This fucking beard is weird.
I'm talking about facts. You're talking about man buns. Let's talk about it.
Still can't cover up the facts. Your last 4 hours as bad as a selfie. Hello, Marshall. My name's Colson. You should go back to recovery.
Yo, Slim. Your last 4 albums suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot. That was 3 albums ago. What do you know? Oops. Know your facts before you come at me, little goof.
Did it bother you for Eminem to mention your daughter? Like, here's an autograph for your daughter? Because
No.
I know people get
Where's
very
it?
Sensitive.
Where's it at?
Did you ask him for an autograph?
It is on
daughter?
The starter cap.
Yeah, where's it at?
Did you ask him for an autograph for your daughter?
Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap.
And here's an autograph for your brother. I wrote it on a starter cap.
No, honestly, I don't think my daughter would want it. She texted me when that Kill Shot came out and was like, eh. You know what I mean?
At nine years old,
you can't even offend a 9-year-old? All right, bro.
I'm sick of your blonde hair and earrings. It's because you look in the mirror and think that you're Marshall Mathers. Don't mean you are and you're not about it. So just leave my dick in your mouth and keep my daughter outie.
Do you feel like a stan?
Do I?
Yeah.
I'm from the Midwest. I'm from Cleveland. I grew up 3 hours away from Detroit. I'm a white boy who's in a predominantly black neighborhood. Definitely in a predominantly black industry. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, I'm fucking with Eminem growing up.
You broke, bitch, yeah. I had enough money in 02 to burn it in front of you, ho. Younger me, no, you'd have whacked me. It's funny, but so true. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you.
He said he'd rather be 80-year-old him than 20-year-old you.
That was the best line he had in the whole
That's
song.
That's kind of a remix of a Jay-Z
and to
line,
be, and
too.
To, and yeah, I was about to say, the fact that that is the line we're talking about, or the puff line, maybe? Like, that's the hotline?
Kill Shot, I will not fail. I'm with the doc still, but this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills. But Kel's the day you put out a hit, the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out, they got pop kill, ah.
The first thing I thought was, and I listened to it, and the first thing I thought was, this shit is cheese, but the artwork is fire. Let's also say it like it is. You took 2 weeks, I took 2 days. You used the Ronnie J track, I used the Ronnie J track. You used a $1 million studio, I used the dressing room before soundcheck. You called me a mumble rapper? Oh my.
Yeah, that was
like
stupid.
Can we just pour some out for this old dumbass?
Now I got a cockback aim, yeah, bitch, pop champagne to this. It's your moment. This is it. As big as you're gonna get, so enjoy it. Had to give you a career to destroy it.
Why not hit him with another shot just to prove your point, though?
Because this wasn't even on my path anyway. And I had just had this, like, this whole week was, you know, all the energy was spent beefing with this dude. Starts to die down. All right, cool. I need to, like, you know what I'm saying? I need to go get away. Because I need to get away. There was other stuff going on. I was supposed to play in, like, whatever. And I really just needed a break, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm already over it. You see, I'm already over it. Binge comes out tonight at midnight.
So is this going to be addressed at all? Anything, some shots, anything on this new project that you didn't anticipate putting out right now?
This is the project.
That's the other thing I saw too. They said that the concert was a Fall Out Boy concert, and that wasn't even your crowd. And the crowd didn't even
know
why they were.
Well, he's opening on tour.
I know, but the crowd didn't know why they were throwing their middle fingers up or nothing like that.
You edited, you fake edited booze into a performance of me performing Rap Devil. Like, one, it's not. There's a real video and a fake video.
Gotcha.
And we have both.
So I saw you posted.
We can watch the real video. It's on Worldstar as well. You can watch the real video and you can watch the booze one. It sounds like a wrestling video for real.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? It's that much of a joke. You know, I even see today the diss, you know, it's the most popular diss.
On YouTube.
On YouTube. Everyone wants to tune in to see, the legend just got punched in the mouth. You know, he wrote Rap Devil 7 months ago.
I saw that too.
The footage is right here. I recorded it in a dressing room 10 feet away from the locker room that I popped that champagne in. I recorded that Friday, the day he released his shit. I did Rap Devil in 4 hours, video, all that. That was a 4 hour, you know what I'm saying? Only Ghost Rider was a pill of Adderall. my track records of beef isn't Christina Aguilera and Mariah Carey.
You did have a bunch of tweets where you was fanboying about Eminem.
Absolutely.
Crazy.
And let's look at the dates on those tweets. Like 2010, we're
like
bringing up.
You were saying he was your idol.
Absolutely. I said he was my idol on his diss record to him. And I'm speaking on the world, you know what I'm saying? I don't even know why everyone's riding for this man so tough. This is a person who won't even show up to do a real interview.
Meaning that Sway works for Shade 45, so it's all stage, it's all, yeah, yeah, yeah.
But then when you get on Tech N9ne's album, and you start sending shots.
The fuck's wrong with you pop tarts? I pop cherries and pop stars, and pop sickles is not hard. Popped in on the top charts, not the cop card, so remind y'all, you just rap, you not God.
You just rap, you not God. Some shit like that, and I was like,
a reference to the Rap God song.
Yeah. Yeah, and by the way, this was on the heels of the freestyle he had just did about Shade 45. It's like, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up.
He said he wants you to shut the fuck up.
I wish he would shut the fuck up. You know what else? No, quote him correct. You're talking about from the interview?
Yes.
Quote him correctly.
I don't remember.
Shut the fuck up. Quote him correctly. His own, he had to produce and hire his own interview and still couldn't stutter his way. He sounded like a bitch, man.
First, when he said, I'm the greatest rapper alive since my favorite rapper banned me from Shade 45 or whatever he said, right? Like, I'm trying to hinder his career. So I don't give a fuck about your career. You think I actually fucking think about you? You know how many rappers that are better than you? You're not even in the fucking conversation. I don't care if you fucking blow or if you don't blow.
I think you should let that second Eminem disc go just for the culture one time. I'm seriously, why people paying attention to you and they saying MGK can rap, why not give him another 16 or whatever?
Because they're about to get 9 tracks tonight.
There you go.
Can it be a bonus track? Hey, man, you got to sell records, baby.
So regardless of what the fuck he wants to say, oh, it was from 6 years ago. Motherfucker, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. I'm telling you the reason I dissed you now.
No more Eminem, even if he sends something else? Done. No more G-Eazy, so.
I'm out here. See you guys. See y'all at the party.
Yeah.